loving one another as he loved us. It needs to be in everything we do as church, not just our worship, but the way we keep books and handle our finances and take care of our buildings and look after the people in need and look after those who are sick or in hospital or in jail. Whatever it is that we're doing, everything. Everything that we do is spiritual practice. We're not going to end poverty. The church is not going to end poverty. Contrary to popular opinion, we're just not capable of doing that. But we can help. And in helping, that is spiritual practice. It's not only for the recipient of the aid, it's for us as well. Givers receive. It's a system. It's a system. If there are no recipients, givers are just out of luck. The giver has to be open to receiving as well. It's part of the humility of that. It's so easy to look down on those who receive aid from the church. For us to be Mother Bountiful. Oh, you poor little thing. We're all about two paychecks away from the street. All the things that we do, whether it is in our ministries, in church, it's our everyday life, every time we have an interaction with a person, every time we see somebody on the street with their hand up, every time there's a checker in the store having a hard time, every time we encounter another human being, that is an opportunity for spiritual practice. That is an opportunity for us to practice becoming Christ's anointed one. There is no busy work. No busy work. Everything we do, it's all part of discipleship. There is that active, you might say, social, spiritual practice that comes in everyday life. There's also the part, and I don't know what else to call it, but the bookish side. We need to learn. Too many folks make assumptions, usually based on their own prejudices, about what it is that Jesus taught. It is really, really important for us to sit down with the scripture, sit down with commentaries, and not just one, because that's just one person's opinion. But to sit down, to get in groups, when a class is off, when Father Nick offers a class, sign up, go. You don't know everything. None of us do. It's important to know what it is that's being said in these books. The two areas play off on that. There's also the area of just silence, of prayer. Opening oneself to the divine indwelling, which is not nearly Louisville way. That's quite a claim for such a bunch of folks. And we need to nurture that body. It's a very immature body at this stage of our development. At best, we're kind of an early adolescent, kind of crashing around into things, not quite sure of our footing, thought we knew everything, now we're not so sure. But we have this opportunity to be co-creators with God of this magnificent creation of which we are part. We're not separate from creation. We are an integral part of it. We have an opportunity to step into that role. And our part is this growing maturity. And that growing maturity is involved in stewarding this creation. Don't soil the nest. Being a part of this is why we have this intellect, why we have language, why we have this seeming top of the food chain role. It gives us the capability both to be co-creative, but also to continue to grow into the prototype, which we see in Jesus. The prototypical human being, there he is. We've seen. We don't know exactly what he looked like. It probably wasn't those pictures of that European guy. But we've seen in the stories, we've heard the stories, we've got Paul, who never actually met him, but seemed to have had a spiritual encounter with him. He was opened up to that divine indwelling in a way that is worthy of our listening to what he has to say. This is a path of transformation. It's not only the transformation of each of us individually into wiser, happier, healthier, more open, neighborly people. It's not just about being nice. But it's about transforming the human race. And each one of us in our lives has an opportunity to bump the bar up just our little bit. So when the next generation comes in, the bar is already a little higher. And keep doing that. As bad as things seem, they're better than they have been in a lot of times in human history. Most women don't die in childbirth. There's less war than there's ever been. Things are better. Just keep bumping it up. Bumping it up. But it's not just about the human race, but because of the role that we have in God's creation, the whole of creation will be improved by our maturity, by our growing up into the full stature of Christ. That's pretty much it. That's pretty much the sermon you've been hearing from me since 2000. They say every preacher's got one. As I have experienced you over these decades, is that you as a group, as people, have these surges. And then there's a stumble, and then there's surges and surges, and this, and there's growth, and there's in spirit, and then there will be a stumble, and then things will get a little freaked out, and oh, funny, and oh my God. And then, we're fine. And there's this, kind of like the rest of the world, right? But what you manage to do here is through all of that, you pretty much continue to like each other. And there tends to be a smile. And you still know how to have some fun. And it's and yet at the same time you take this whole thing seriously. So I guess what I would say in closing is keep it up. Amen.
Amen.